everyone, Bryan here. Welcome back to my channel. In the previous tutorial, we learned how to set up a dev wallet on Chainweaver. Today, we'll be using Chainweaver to run some basic Pact scripts. Let's open up Chainweaver. Log in and navigate to the contract tab on the left. You will see the screen broken into two parts. On the left is a code editor which should be empty, and on the right there should be a bunch of tabs. We will be using the code editor later for writing more complex codes. Today, we will be only doing very basic things. You can click on the REPL tab on the right. REPL allows us to write code and see its outputs. It is an acronym for read ever print loop, which just means that it reads code and shows it on the screen. Alright, let's write some code. To the left of where it say pack, type plus 11 and press enter. It should show you 2. Let's break this down. In pack, brackets show that we want to run some code and get the result of that code. In this case, we are telling pack to execute plus 11 and return the result to the screen. This is known as printing to the screen. In pact, we specify operations by first saying what kind of operation we want to do. Operations are commonly referred to as functions. In this case, the plus symbol indicates we want to run the addition function. In pact, after the function symbol or name, we pass in the values with which we want to run it. So in this case, we are passing 1 and 1 to the addition function, which as expected shows you 2. Now try this with plus 15. This should give you 6. Hope this makes sense so far. Next, we can get a little fancy. We can add two words together. Luckily, the plus function can also be used to take words. Type this into your REPL. Plus. This will output hello world. An important thing to pay attention to here is the fact that hello and world have quotation marks around them. This tells Pact that we are giving it a bunch of characters and not something like a function name. These characters can be letters or numbers. In programming, we call a bunch of characters a string. Let's try add another string. In this case, since we put quotes around the ones, it treats them as characters and appends them next to each other. Lastly, we'll learn how to do nested operations. For example, what if we want to do 2 plus 1 and then plus 4? First, we can do 2 plus 1 like this. Next, we want to add 4 to it. So we can do it like this. Okay, now that might look scary, but it all makes sense. In this case, we are telling Pact we want to call the plus function. The plus function takes the output of plus 21 and also 4 as its input. Pact, we evaluate plus 21 first, which will be 3, and then add 4, which will make it 7. Take some time to play around with things if this is confusing. However, once you get the hang of this idea, you'll be able to start doing quite complex things in the future. That's all for this tutorial. Thanks for watching. Remember to hit the like button, leave a comment, and subscribe to my channel. I'll see you in the next video.